County is losing the fight against the coronavirus. This is according to doctors at St. Francis and the Tulsa County Health Department. Tonight, our Vincent Hill is working for you with how you can keep your family and your community safe. Vincent.
Mike, today a frank warning from those at the front lines fighting COVID-19. Tulsa County is not where it should be, and things could soon get worse.
I never thought after the Army I'd be on another battlefield, yet here we are.
Dr. Richard Dallop with St. Francis Hospital says Oklahoma is at war with the coronavirus. He's on the front line every day.
We are headed in the wrong direction.
The CEO of St. Francis says there's a troubling uptick in hospitalizations.
Last week, St. Francis Health System hit a peak of 129 patients in our hospitals.
That's up 50% from this summer.
If we're going to prevent the spread of this virus, it's time to get serious about prevention efforts.
Dr. Bruce Dart with the Tulsa County Health Department says we're in the time of the year that concerns him the most.
If you really want to know what keeps me up at night, it's a twin threat of COVID-19 and influenza. You can be infected with both.
Dr. Dart recommends you get a flu shot this season and make changes to your holiday plans.
The smaller gatherings at home, at the office, or other enclosed spaces where people have a false sense of security and do not wear masks and gather in close proximity with a few friends or extended family, these settings have been proven to be high-risk settings for transmission.
Dr. Dart says there's no plan to mandate how many people can attend holiday gatherings, but he recommends less than 10 people. He also says not being able to contact trace could be contributing to a rise in cases in Tulsa County.
Sadly, the majority of individuals declined to provide contact information for close contacts or places they have been.
Dart says just over 2.2% of people who test positive in Tulsa County provide close contact information.
Effort to get more people to give that vital information for contact tracing, the Tulsa Health Department implemented an online link for anyone who tests positive to answer those questions. Now, it launched on Monday, so it's too early to know if it's been effective yet to track more potential cases. Karen?